Welcome everybody to the FISU World University Games in Chengdu. We're right in the middle of the Sichuan province in West China. We're here in the Pidim Gymnasium for the sixth and final day of fencing. It's the third day of team competitions and it's time for the men's foil and women's saber team competitions. So here we go with the bronze medal match between China and Italy. So 4-1, Lombardi doing well here against the sub. And one more will do it for the Italian. And the Italian does it. So Lombardi, the European junior champion from last year, showing he's got some considerable skills and one to watch for the future, the youngster, Giulio Lombardi. Well, it was a counter-attack from Mangaliolo. It wasn't his right of the way, but Cao missed on his attack. The attack passed, it went over the shoulder of Mangaliolo. And that will see us to 40-30. We go into the final period with a 10-point lead and Huang, coming on for China, has some serious work to do. Martini only needs two more to see this out, but Huang's on a roll, 6-3. Counter-attack there at the back of the piece for Martini, brings Italy just 1 point away from claiming the bronze medal. And there it is, the para riposte from Martini has gained Italy the bronze. Confirmation that Italy have taken the bronze medal in the men's foil competition. Italy win that one, 45-36. Well, time now for the gold medal match in the men's team foil competition. And it is France versus Hong Kong, China. Pick the right timing to finish the attack there. Referee called halt there because Lee had somehow managed to get his arm stuck under the arm of Maximilian Chastanet. Well, Lee's quick when he goes forward. Yeah. One more required for Lee. And there it is. A comfortable lead and good work from Lee from Hong Kong. Well, referee Mads Herjolf is going to have a look at that one of his own volition. And gives it to the French team. Sudo's had some luck going forwards, but that time Choi is able to find the power riposte. And Hong Kong are 1 point away from going into the final leg with a commanding lead. There we go, well constructed. And that is that for the eighth. 40-28 the score. Loisel doing great work there. Thought that Chung had got the parry, but couldn't land. Again, Chung backing off. And that time, with his foot right on the back line, Chung is able to take the point. Four more for Hong Kong. We'll see them through to the gold medal. Well, Chung is pretty happy being right on the back line. He does some good work in defense here. His toe there glued to the line. And look at that. Well, a wry half smile there. Well, referee just looking to see if there was a preparation there for Loisel. And that's exactly what she called preparation on Loisel. Simple from Chung Ka Long, and Hong Kong are 1 point away from claiming the gold medal here. Big long attack, can he finish with a flurry? Oh, they've crossed. And Loisel able to hit with the one attempt. Counter from Loisel. Loisel coming in with a counter. And last few points have gone to the French. Yellow card shown to Chung. Well, that's that. A scrappy ending to the match, but the lead that Hong Kong had developed throughout this gold medal match was insurmountable, and that final period ending 5 apiece and Hong Kong winning against France 45-33. So congratulations to the medalists in the men's team foil competition. Hong Kong, China take gold, France take the silver, and Italy the bronze. Well, time now for the women's team sabre bronze medal match between Italy and Uzbekistan. So Yulia Arpinok for Italy and Aysulya Oznatdinova for Uzbekistan. Uznatdinova, well, she's done okay in this competition so far. She's fought twice already. She had a 5-4 against her, so 1 point shipped, and then 5-all in the second. So currently sitting on a -1 going into this leg, and has started very fast against Arpino. Arpino had the big loss against Dybekova, the 10-2 defeat, so Arpino attacking now. Can she finish it? Yes, she can. So good, important points for Arpino. And has leveled the scores. So the line was out there. So the referee is going to have a look at the video review. But he's given it point and line. So the line was out from Uznatdinova, and she wins that one 9-4 over Yulia Arpino. So a 3 point lead to Uzbekistan. And they are racing away to that target score of 40. And this could be a big, big leg for Podabieva. If she can finish here, no, she can't. Gaganyo's building the attack. That was a huge point. If Podabieva had scored that hit, then they would have taken a really comfortable lead through. Now Gaganyo has a chance. So nothing given. on the review. Gargano's attack, simple, but Debayeva couldn't find the parry. Still now just a 1 point lead to Uzbekistan. Debayeva couldn't finish. Can the Italian Gargano, she's still attacking. No, there's a parry there. Parry, counter parry, and it's gone to Uzbekistan. And Uzbekistan are 1 point away from claiming the bronze medal here. Pissarro's attack. She finishes it. So just 2 points in it. Pissarro just still needs to believe. Pissarro backing off. Dybekova finishes nicely, and that's it. Uzbekistan have won the bronze medal. A huge, huge win for this young team. And Uzbekistan win that one, 45-42. So time now for the final contest, the final medal to be decided here. And it is the gold medal match between France and the USA. Poupinet off the line quicker. Poupinet has the line out. So Pack must do something. The line is now gone. Pack finishes the attack. So when you have point in line, you have to keep that point in line. Good attack from Poupinet. No, it was attack from right. Pack's attack, can't finish. Now Poupinet comes forward. And a clash of feet there, 4-1. Poupinet restoring some of this French lead. And that was a big win for Poupinet, a big win. Good start from Von Zavadi. And the best start possible for the French team. Oh. Well, I thought Nazimov just about was going to get away with that and get out of the way. But by the narrowest of margins. And Nazlimov now has made things very difficult for herself. Those 3 points from Von Zavadi. Nazlimov's attack from the left. Lovely stuff from the young American. Well, when you get a roll in Sabre, American attacking and finishing. So Nazlimov's got to 5. If she can get to 7 or 8, before Von Zavadi sees this one through to 40, then she'll be very happy with her work in this eighth leg. Now, they both came in, they stopped, they started again. Nazlimov, for me, started, stopped, and Von Zavadi picked up the right of way. So a point stands, and Vong Savity just one away. So if Nazimov can score two now, attack from the right was parried by Nazimov. America needs maybe two or three more. 1 point at a time to give her teammate Chloe Fox-Gittema a chance in the ninth against Nucha. Well, it was called as power riposte. There's no video. And Nazimov unhappy. It's only 1 point that she was able to get back. It's an 8 point deficit. Chloe Fox-Gittema coming on for the USA. So the final leg is underway. And America taking the first point. A good start, so important here for Fox-Gittema. So Nucha just looking for the blade there and concedes that to the referee. Fox-Gittema now defending Nucha's attack. Well, parry, counter parry, point to Nucha, and Fox-Gittema is asking for a video review. So there was two meetings of the blade. You could hear it in the hall. Point stands, Nucha's. A slap of the thigh for Chloe Fox-Gittema. Frustration there, it's two apiece, 42-34. The French are getting excited now. 2 points away. A lovely little stop cut from the French fencer there. Fox-Gittema's attack and Nucha nipping in, hitting her on the wrist and then diving out of the way. So the French just 1 point away from finishing this, and they've done it. The French have taken the gold medal here at the World University Games. The French established an early lead and were able to cruise for victory. 45-34. So congratulations to our medalists in the women's team sabre competition, the last gold medal to be decided, and it's gone to France. USA taking the silver and Uzbekistan the bronze.